coffee. Okay, coffee. Yeah. So coffee are of two types, Arabica and Robusta. So Arabica grows in India and it is stronger than the Robusta. This is Arabica. Okay, and Robusta is like a big tree. Okay, this is a small bush and that is big tree. Okay, and it is stronger than the Robusta. Like, can you see here the green berries?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, so that green berries turns to red, it is ready to harvest. After harvesting, it is dried, roasted and then powdered. Okay, so berries are of two types, the male berry and the female berry. So male berry contain two seeds in it and the female berry contain only one seed. So only the male berry which contain two seeds in it go for coffee and females are kept for sapling. Means to grow another plant. Okay? See here. Can you see? This is male, contain two seeds slightly in it. And this is female, slightly bent like. Can you see? And this contain only one seed. This is female. And this is male.
Arabia?
Arabica. Both are Arabica. This is female and this is male. Contain two seeds is the male and contain one seed is the female. You know betel nut, bittle supari, betel nut, betel nut, areca nut.
Khan was the senior.
Okay, I'll show you while walking. Okay, actually, betel is a nut.
Nut,
which is used in a combination of leaf, pan. Okay, yeah, with lime paste, tobacco, and other spices. The leaf is chewed and liquid is spat out. Okay, the red color liquid. So we count the age of the palm by the number of rings. Okay. Okay. So three rings per year.
Okay.
Like 1, 2, and 3. This is for 1 year. Again 1 year like this. Okay. Three rings per year. And on top you can see the betel nut. Here. There also you can see. Back side of yours.
Yeah.
Okay. That's betel nut. Raw one. Okay. That is raw now. So it is one raw betel nut is equivalent to 30 ml of whiskey. 30 ml. Of whiskey. Okay, one raw betel nut.
Yes.
And when it turns orange in color, the time we harvest that betel nut, he climbs on one palm, he throws the betel nut bunch down and he swings from one palm to another palm. Just like monkey. Okay, this is flexible. So they just bend this and jump. The small, small berries on this. Can you guess what it is?
Pepper.
You know pepper, white, black pepper,
black pepper.
So that's the pepper, like all the peppers, kali miri ma. Okay, so all the peppers, green pepper, red pepper, white pepper and black pepper, all four peppers are from one single creeper. Okay, but the processing is different.
Yes.
Like now it is green in color, when it turns red in color, that time we harvest that and the red one, you dry it in sunlight, you'll get the black pepper. If you dry it in sunlight. And if you harvest the red one and you boil it in water.
The red one.
Boil it in water, the outer cover goes off and you'll get the white pepper inside.
Okay.
White pepper. And that white pepper is mildest, not spicy. The strongest is the black pepper.
Black pepper.
And it's very good for acidity. The black pepper. What you have to do? Take a cup of black tea without sugar, black tea, okay? Yes. And 2-3 peppers, not more than 3. Just 2-3 peppers, crush it and stir it in that cup of black tea. Very good for acidity or indigestion, wind problem.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So actually, there are many types of banana. You know, like sakhar dandi banana, ilaichi banana, butter banana. So this is a butter banana, which is a little bit sour in taste. Okay, and this is the second tallest grass in the world, the banana grass. It is not a tree, not a plant. It is of grass family.
Okay,
okay? The second tallest grass. Yeah, and the you know the first one.
No.
First one is the bamboo.
Bamboo.
Bamboo is the first tallest grass. Second is the banana grass, and the third tallest is the sugarcane grass.
Sugarcane.
Sugarcane. Okay, and we use all the parts of this grass, like the green leaves. This green leaves are used to eat the food because it has lot of chlorophyll inside and it's very good for digestion. Okay, that green leaves. If we eat food on the green leaves, just like a plate. Okay? Mm-hmm. And this dried leaves, this I used to make bidi. You know bidi? Yeah. The local cigarette.
Oh.
The local cigarette. We use make of this. Okay? And this I used to make garlands, the outer stem.
This one?
Okay, yeah, the thread of that.
The rope.
Yeah, the rope. Okay, yes. And there is a white color stem inside. Okay, this core. So that I used to make vegetable. To make vegetable.
Sabji.
Sabji.
Food, huh?
Food, yeah. In cooking. Okay, so it has a lot of calcium, vitamins in it. It's very good to make a vegetable. And there you can see the bunch, the banana bunch,
yeah.
And that small fly is hanging, blackish color. So cardamom are of three types, black cardamom, white cardamom and green cardamom, elaichi. Okay. So in our plantation, we grow only the green cardamom because it has a good medicinal property, while the black one and white one doesn't have the medicinal value in it. It is only used for cooking purpose, just for flavor. The black and white cardamom. And the green cardamom grows on the shoot. Can you see that shoot?
Mm-hmm.
And that small cardamom is there. Can you see that? Only one is there.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Green cardamom. Mm-hmm. Here also you can see. There are two here. So on this shoot. Can you see?
Yeah.
It looks like button.
Yeah.
It's small. Here.
Okay.
Like the leaves like this and here it goes, but not on this same plant, okay? The other plant, yeah. And this is only one bush, and on one bush we get only 30 to 40 grams of cardamom per year. It is once in a year, okay? Once in a year, and we get only 30 to 40 grams, yeah. And that's why it is the third most expensive spice in the world. Third most expensive spice, and also called queen of the spices. And the tea, what you had as a welcome drink, the lemongrass tea.
Yes.
It has also cardamom in it, because the outer husk of the cardamom is very good for memory. Okay, the outer husk, boiled in milk, and just drink, preferably in the evening time. Very good as an antidepressant. Okay. Looks like snake. Alternative leaves. Okay, that's the second most expensive spice in the world.
Vanilla.
Vanilla. Yeah, vanilla. So, it is not a creeper. It is an orchid. Orchid. Okay. Yeah, orchid. So, it doesn't need soil to grow.
Mm-hmm.
It is growing on the palm trees. Okay, and it is also not a parasite, because it doesn't harm the other plant. It only extracts the water from the palm. Okay, and After 3 years, an orchid gives first flower and then the many flower, and the pollination is done with the hands, not by the nature. The birds, insect doesn't do the pollination. We do it manually here. But in Madagascar, there is a country called Madagascar, there they find the bees called Melipona bees. So they are doing the pollination there, the bees. But here we are not finding the Melipona bees, so we are doing it manually by hands. Okay, and after pollination, it takes 9 months for the pod to get ready, just like human being. First, it is green in color. Okay, so after 9 months, it turns to yellow color. So when it turns yellow color, the pod get harvested and dried in sunlight only for 1 hour, not more than 1 hour, and then in the shade till it turns brown in color. So when it turns brown in color, the pod get ready and it is exported to US and UK. Okay, because only these two countries have the secret formula how to extract the oil from that pod. Okay, and 50% oil is used by medicinal pharmaceutical, 20% are used in a French perfume company, and 30% are used in Coca-Cola and Pepsi. Because in Coca-Cola and Pepsi, they use phosphor and it has a bad smell. To take out that smell, they use the vanillin. Okay, just for essence, yeah. And that pod, that long stick, can be used in the kitchen also. Like take 1 kg of sugar and one vanilla, okay? And one pod, means one stick, is enough for 5 kg of sugar. That much concentrated. Cacao. Chocolate. Okay, cocoa. Cacao. Okay, so here you can see the papaya like fruit. Yeah. So now it is green in color. But when it turns yellow in color.
There is yellow one.
Yeah. That is one is there. So when it turns yellow in color, we harvest that pod. Okay. First it is green in color. Yeah. So before the bud blooms on tree, we hand picked that. It's like in bunches. Okay. We hand picked and dried in sunlight till it turns brown in color. So actually, there are two types of cloves, the black one and the brown one. So brown one is with oil and black one is after extracting the oil. What you get in the market is the black one. Rarely you'll get the brown one. And that brown one with oil is very good for toothache, dental problems, normally used by the dentist. Also in toothpaste, mouth freshness, okay? Yeah. And also we extract the oil from the leaves. And it is very good mosquito repellent, the oil from the leaves. Peri peri chili.
Peri peri.
Peri peri.
Peri peri.
Also piri piri.
Piri piri.
Piri piri chili. Okay.
Chokaju.
So
this is piri piri chili.
Yeah, this is the maximum size of this chili. So small but so spicy.
Yeah.
It is 2,800 times spicy than the normal chili what you get in the market. Yeah, very spicy. We have dish called pickle and papad made from this chili. After it's, you can taste in the lunch. Okay, very spicy. Yeah.
No, thank you.
Nutmeg. Muscat.
Muscat.
Muscat.
Muscat. Yeah.
Muscat
nutmeg. Jaifal. Okay. Yeah, nutmeg. So when this fruit get matured on the tree, it opens by itself. Okay, and the nutmeg and the outer cover mace. Both falls down. Okay, and you get two spices from one fruit, jaifal and jayavatri. Okay, and nutmeg and mace.
Yeah, they get that flower as well. As
yeah, the round one is like this, yeah. And the outer cover is like this. Okay, and then the fruit.
Yeah,
I'll say. So that both are used to make masala, garam masala. Okay, but the outer cover mace. I used to make tear gas, which is used by police.
Tear gas,
ah. Turkey'de çok kullanılıyor. Terörist and all.
Tear gas, şaşırtıcı gaz.
Tear gas.
And round one, that is nutmeg, is very good for gout. You know gout? The uric acid.
Ha, gout hastalığı.
Yeah, the water collected in the joints and all here or here or here you get. Okay. So what you have to do? Take one nutmeg full, okay, and make powder out of that one nutmeg, and half lemon juice, the normal lemon juice, and little paste of ginger. Mix it, make a paste and apply on the affected area. You'll get relief in 15 to 20 days. Not to drink, just to apply. It's very strong.
It's a taste.
Yeah, it's very strong, so you can't eat it directly.
Garam masala.
Garam masala, yeah. But actually this is a hybrid plant, not the original. It's a hybrid plant brought from Mexico. Okay, Mexico, and we get berries from this plant. Like in houses, what we do for garam masala, to make garam masala, we make a yeah, we collect all the spices and grind them and make the garam masala. But here the case is totally different. We get small berries from this plant, just like pepper, small berries, and then it turns red in color. So when it turns red in color, the berries get harvested and we dried them in sunlight and then make powder out of that. Okay, that's the garam masala here. It is also called allspice, also called five spice, because it has aroma of five different spices: cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, nutmeg and coriander. Okay, all five spice in one plant. Okay, and these leaves are also used in rice dishes like pulao or fried rice, biryani. Yeah, just like bay leaf, not the bay leaf, ma'am. Just like that. Okay. Outside the fruit, the lower portion is the nut and the upper portion is the fruit. Okay. Fruit is either yellow in color or orange red in color. Okay. So when this fruit get ready, means when this fruit get matured on the tree, it falls down automatically on the ground. Okay. Then we collect all the fruits and bring it here. Then we separate the nut from the fruit, and nut are send it to the factory for further process. Okay, and what you get in the market, that cashew nut and all. And the upper portion, that yellow portion, we crushed here by the feet like this. Okay, and we take out the juice from that pipe. We keep barrels over there. We collect all the juice in the barrel and keep it for fermentation, just like 4 to 5 days. Okay, then we take out the fermented juice and boil in this tank. at 100 degrees Celsius. Then the first distill we get is the urraq. Called urraq, it has only 10 to 12% of alcohol in it.
Arak.
Just 10 yani. To 12%.
Urraq is arak, yeah?
Yeah, urraq.
Aynı kelime. Arak, arak.
Kaju
likör mü? Kaju
rakısı. Then we take out the first distill, that is urraq, and the next fermented juice. We mix it both and boiled again in this tank. The second distill we get is the feni. It has 40 to 42% of alcohol in it. Very strong.
İki defa damıtılmış oluyor.
Just like 1 to 2 sip is very good for cold, cough. Okay, and if you take more, then you feel like
dizzy.
This tsunami.
Why?
Without music, you have to dance.